utilizzare io. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. Assalamu wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytani al-la'in al-rajim. Bismillahi ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nasta'hdihi wa nasta'gfiruhu wa natubu ilayh. ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا وطبيب نفوسنا وشفيع ذنوبنا أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد ما صلى على محمد وعلى محمد طب القلوب ودوائها ونور أبصارها وعلى أهل بيته الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد بهم نتولى ومن أعدائهم نتبرى إلى يوم القيامة عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل يقول أمير المؤمنين صلوات الله وسلامه عليه اللهم صل على محمد وعلى محمد أول الدين معرفته وكمال معرفته التصديق به وكمال التصديق به توحيده وكمال توحيده إخلاص له وكمال إخلاص له نفي الصفات عنه صلوا على محمد وآل محمد اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد Once again we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us this opportunity and this moment to observe our weekly Eid, which is Jum'ah. I first and foremost admonish myself and each and every one of you, mu'mineen and mu'minat, lovers and followers of Ahlul Bayt, to have the consciousness of the teachings of Almighty Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. As you know very well, brothers and sisters, Allah Azza wa Jal, in numerous verses of glorious Quran, remind us of the importance of consciousness, or taqwa, as Quran terms it. We've been looking into Nahjul Balagha in trying to extract few lessons that I and you can try as much as we can to implement in our lives to become sincere and true servants of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As you know very well, and as we mentioned last week, the essence of life to us Muslims is to become a true abd of Allah. All these endeavors that we have in terms of worshiping Allah is to get to that level of having the feeling of Allah or His presence wherever we find ourselves. The lines I've just quoted are beautiful lines of Nahjul Balagha that Imam alayhi salam mentioned. Awwaluddini ma'rifatuh, the foremost in the religion is the acknowledgement of him. Ma'rifa, generally translated to be knowing. Inshallah we'll shed more light on it later. Then he said, "Wa kamalu ma'arifatihi at-tasdiqu bih." And the perfection of his acknowledgement is to testify him. "Wa kamalu tasdiqihi tawhiduh." And the perfection of testifying him is to believe in his oneness, isn't it? And then the last one, وَكَمَالُ تَوْحِيدِهِ إِخْلَاصَلَ. And the perfection of believing in his oneness is to regard him pure. Now these lines that you see on the screen, mu'minin and mu'minat, there are additional ones which inshallah we'll do next week. These lines are no doubt crash course on obtaining the ma'rifah of Allah. As some scholars mentioned, if you are to bring all the books written in the field of Tawheed and join them together, compared to this line will overpower all those books. That's the eloquence of Imam Amir al-Mu'mineen. These lines, brothers and sisters, talks about five levels of Tawheed. You cannot be a Muslim without Tawheed. Tawheed is everything. You can claim to be whoever you are. If you miss out on Tawheed, then there is no even room for negotiating that you are out of Islam. These lines discuss Tawheed, monotheism, and it discusses five levels of Tawheed. The first level, it talks about ma'rifa ijmali lillahi azza wa jal. General knowledge about Allah. Some of us, we've got general knowledge in our understanding when it comes to Allah. That's the first step of achieving Tawheed. The second stage that this line is highlighting is ma'rifa at-tafsiliya lillahi azza wa jal. Detailed knowledge about the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the third stage of tawheed that this line is shedding is talking about the tawheed of essence and the tawheed of attributes. And if you recall very well, not to confuse you, we mentioned about attributes of Allah last week. That attribute of Allah are his essence, and his essence are his attributes. When we say attribute, essence, just for our own understanding. Otherwise, there is nothing like attribute when it comes to Allah. Everything is in Allah's existence. But for our understanding, because there is no one who will be able to reach kun hakikat al-ilahi, who will be able to reach the peak of the peak of the understanding of the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We only try our level best through his attributes. And the third level of Tawheed that this line are talking about is ikhlas, sincerity. You know, if there is one thing that we all struggle with, it's our ikhlas. I want to show off when I stand here. I want to show you that I've got the knowledge. I want to show you my muscles. When you deal with me in something else, you want to show me you know better than me. Ta'annutan. Our biggest headache is not that we are not good. It's not that we are not doing a lot. Wallah, we are doing so much. Our biggest problem is doing it for the sake of Allah and not for people to praise you. So ikhlas is a level of tawheed. You know how many people in our community, when they do something, you don't recognize them, they become sad. People, when they give money, if you tell them, I will say Bande Khuda, they say, no, you're jealous of me. Mention my name. Say, Baba, I forgot to mention your name. He said, no, mention the name. I'm not saying it's wrong to mention people's name. It's good to mention people's name to encourage others. But if your name is not being mentioned, إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا نَخَافُ مِنْ رَبِّنَا يَوْمًا عَبُوسًا قَمْطَرِيرًا. That's what we inherited from Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. You do it for the sake of Allah. You get appreciated, fine, bonus. You do not get appreciated, no worries. Allah sees it and he appreciates it. And the last stage of tawheed that these lines are talking about, nafyu tashabih, aw tashbih, is to negate the likeness to Allah. That there is nothing or no one is like Allah. وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٍ. Now let's begin with the lines. I want you to kindly pay attention. It will not take much of your time. The line says, the first ingredient of religion is ma'arifa of Allah. Now what is religion to begin with? You know very well, religion, set of rules, wajibat, aqaid and akhlaq. These are religion. So in this religion, there are those who are expert in history. They've got ma'arifa of history. There are those who've got the ma'arifa of social issues. There are those who've got the ma'arifa of other things. The line here is telling us, out of all those ma'arifa, out of all the knowledge that you have, the one on top of all is knowledge about Allah. In other words, to become a true religious person, you must have knowledge about Allah. That is the first step towards becoming a true servant of Allah. أول الدين معرفته. There are different discussions. What is this ma'arifa? Some said ma'arifa means ta'atullah wal inqiyadullah. It's to be obedient to Allah and then obey his teachings and stay away from what he asks you to stay away from. Some said that is the meaning of ma'arifa of Allah. But al-muhim, whatever one know, if it precedes knowledge about Allah, then you have not understood what religion is all about. It is said, ma'rifah of Allah is ashrafu ajza'il ma'rifah. It's the most honorable form of knowledge. And when I talk of ashraf here, scholars mention, it's ashrafu wujudi, it's not akhlaqi, it's not fiqhi. Sometimes I may be very powerful in fiqh. I've got the knowledge. I may be very powerful in usul. I've got the knowledge. I'm very powerful in that. The ashraf of all knowledge is knowledge about Allah. So if they said wujudiyya, they said it is existential. What does it mean to say this sharaf, this honor of having the ma'rifah of Allah is existential? So if we look at the world of existence, you will never come across knowledge that can stand knowledge about Allah. And let me give you a few examples from the glorious Quran to understand how important it is to dedicate our times and our efforts and our energy in trying to understand the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see, in Quran, on numerous occasions, Allah invites us to hold on to the best. Don't settle with good. Don't settle with better. Strive for the best. Few verses of Quran. Quran 7, verse number 3. Ittabi'u ahsana ma unzila ilaykum. Allah is telling us, follow the best of what we have revealed to you. Again, you go Quran 39, verse 18. So, الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْكَوْلَ فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَ. Allah said, those good ones are those who listen to whatever is being said. But after listening, they don't just take everything. They take the best out of what has been said. So always Allah wants us to take the best.
Hence, the knowledge that you and I are striving for. Go for it.
But don't forget the knowledge about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because it's ashraful ulum. Allah, sometimes you find mu'mineen and mu'minat can spend the whole year without finding and dedicating time to read something about Allah. You see, Quran again, 64 verse 16. Allah tells us, Fattakullaha mastata'atum.
Sir, fear Allah according to your capability. Meaning you try in your own way, in your own small way, fear Allah, have the taqwa. But then there is another ayah, Quran 2:3, verse 102.
Said, Ittaqullah haqqa tuqati.
Fear Allah in a true sense of fearing Allah. One ayah said, based on your capability. But this one, he said, no, in a true sense, meaning the true sense is a afdal taqwa. Likewise, when Allah tells us to remember him, one ayah will tell us, "Udhkuru ni'mati allati an'amtu alaykum." Remember the ni'mah I bestowed upon you. But then Allah wants you to follow the best. He said, "Udhkuruni adhkurukum." Remember me, I will remember you. So therefore, Allah or Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam is telling us the best form of knowledge in this deen. If you truly want to enjoy this deen, is to understand the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And now look at the next line. You may have the knowledge, no big deal. But the knowledge may not have any impact on you positively. That's why you want to say, وَكَمَالُ مَعْرِفَتِهِ التَّصْدِيقُ بِهِ. The perfection of acknowledging him is to testify him. That's tasdeeq. What is this tasdeeq? How many people, they have knowledge about Allah, but they still have doubt about Allah? It means there is no tasdeeq. In other words, for your knowledge about Allah to be upheld, there must be tasdeeq at the end of that knowledge. So I give an example. You see, in Islam, we are told to make salat. Salah akimu salah. So many verses of Quran, isn't it? You can pray in your house, fine. You can go to Burring, you find some places, salat time, you pray. Salat is acceptable, habibi. There's nothing wrong with that. You may be driving somewhere and then you pass by a yard, you stop somewhere, garden, park, you pray. Salat is acceptable. Or you may come to the mosque and pray, isn't it? See, when Prophet said, La salata li jari al-masjid illa fil masjid, there is no salat for the neighbor of mosque except in the mosque. Scholars said, Prophet is talking, there is no perfect salat except the salat that is performed in the house of Allah. That salat is accepted. But then if you do it somewhere else, the perfection becomes more. The same way you have the knowledge about Allah in the ma'rifah al-ilahiyah. But if your ma'rifah does not take you to tasdeeq, then that ma'rifah is not a perfect ma'rifah. Now, what is this tasdeeq? There is a correlation between ma'rifah and tasdeeq. Some said ma'rifah, which is here in this line of Nahjul Balagha, it refers to general knowledge about Allah. And some said that general knowledge Allah gave us in our fitrah. They said tasdeeq is detailed knowledge about Allah. And that is why, if you recall very well from the traditions of Prophet and Ahlul Bayt, that the first and foremost thing you teach your children when you begin their upbringing is to teach them the love of Allah. That's the first thing on the shoulder of every parent, to teach our children the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, it's important we understand this tasdeeq is detailed knowledge about Allah Azza wa Jal. That as a Muslim, as a believer, you must keep striving and determining to acquire more about Allah. Well, I tell people, sometimes people come to me, they say, this religion is boring. I said, Allah, you made it boring for yourself. I said, why? I said, because you're not reading. You read half and you left half. Half is not making sense to you, so you thought the entire religion is that half. Hafista shay'an wa gaba anka ashiya. You memorize something and so many things you have skipped them. The more you read, the more you acknowledge and appreciate the religion. And the last thing mu'minin and mu'minat is what? Some scholars said no. This tasdeeq is what? It's iman billahi azza wa jal. That after the ma'rifah, your iman must be seen out there in your action. In other words, you cannot have knowledge about Allah and your akhlaq doesn't show the akhlaq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The more knowledge you have about Allah, the more your akhlaq show. I was telling brothers and sisters on Monday in my class, I said there's a tradition from prophets that the more Islamic knowledge you have, the more humble you become. But today, out there, we see opposite. I said, some of us, Maulana, including myself, if I come to the mosque and I'm not giving VIP service, I feel bad. Because if you give VIP service, I will take it. But if you don't give, what's the problem? So if you have the ma'rifah, there is tasdeeq. If there is tasdeeq, meaning takhallaku bi akhlaqillah. Behave with the manners of Allah. That is the stick. Some Maulana, even if you give them food with everybody, they will not eat. The Prophet used to sit with people and eat in Medina. Ahlul Bayt used to sit and eat in Medina. So therefore, that tasdeeq has to inform the type of knowledge you have. And the last one, some said no. When we talk of tasdeeq and ma'rifah, they said ma'rifah is ilmu billah wa tasdeeku al-yakeenu billah. Ma'rifah, I've got knowledge. Tasdeeq, I am certain about Allah Azza wa Jal. So therefore, in conclusion, mu'minin and mu'minat, you will never finish knowing about Allah. I always tell people, you see, there's a very beautiful tradition where the Holy Prophet mentioned about Amir al-Mu'mineen, isn't it? Where Prophet said to Imam Amir al-Mu'mineen, you know the tradition very well. O Ali, no one knows you better except Allah and I, isn't it? And no one knows me better except Allah and you. But if this is Prophet and Imam Ali, what of Allah? So, the more I know I will not be able to reach the destination, the more I strive and try. But if I fold my arm and be satisfied with the little that I have, then it becomes a big problem. We ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to forgive us our shortcomings. We ask Allah azza wa jal to forgive our marhumin and grant them jannat al-firdausa. We have mu'minin and mu'minat who kindly requested our dua. They are not feeling well. Some are at hospitals. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to cure them with His cure. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar. Fa salli li rabbika wanhar. Inna shani'aka huwal abtar.